The Quran is clever in spite of that, we're still confused. This makes me confused. How can we be confused? Let us begin by this week learning what happens to the true believer at the time of his death and after death. Let us begin by this week learning what happens to the true believer at the time of his death and after death. The hadith can be found in many books narrated by Bara ibn Atib radiallahu ta'ala. He says, خرجنا مع رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم في جنازة رجل من الأمصار فانتحينا إلى القبر ولما يلحد فجلس رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم وجلسنا حوله كأن على رؤوسنا الطير. He relates that a man from the Amsar had died. With the Sahaba went with Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم to offer his funeral prayer. We reached his grave and found that the lahad, the inner chamber of the grave where the body is put inside, is not ready yet. Nabi alayhi salatu wa salam sat down facing Qibla, and we the Sahaba radiallahu ta'ala anhu majma'een sat around Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam with such respect and so still, كَكَأَنَّا عَلَىٰ رُوسِنَا الطَّيْرِ. It was like birds were sitting on our head. This is how respectful and this is how still we were sitting around Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. وفي يد عود ينكت به الأرض. نبي عليه الصلاة والسلام had a stick in his hand. He was sketching on the ground. نبي عليه الصلاة والسلام began to look at the heavens and began to look at the earth, raising and lowering his gaze when he صلى الله عليه وسلم said, استعيذ بالله من عذاب القبر. استعيذ بالله من عذاب القبر. استعيذ بالله من عذاب القبر. He repeated it thrice. O Muslims, seek Allah's protection from the punishment of the grave. Seek Allah's protection from the punishment of the grave. He said it thrice so that this message and the importance of this message enters into the heart of every believer. He said, الله عليه وسلم said to the Sahaba, إن العبد المؤمن إذا كان في انقطاع من الدنيا وإقبال من الآخرة نزل إليه ملائكة من السماء فيض الوجوه كأن وجوههم الشمس ماءهم أكفان من أكفان الجنة وحنوت من حنوت الجنة حتى يجلس منه مد البصر. When a believing person is in the last throes, is on the verge of leaving this world and going to the Akhirah, the angels descend. Angels, white of face. Their faces so beautiful, so bright, that their faces look like as if they are suns, like the sun. And these angels bring with them kafan from Jannah, shroud, sheets of cloth from Jannah. And they bring with them the sweet smell, the oud of Jannah. And these angels come and they sit before the believer at a distance as far as his eye can see. I pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that these very angels descend at the time of our death. But if we want these particular angels, because next week we will look at the angels that will descend at the time of a kafir, at the time of death of a person who lived a life of sin. And then we will definitely say Ameen loud. If we want these very angels to descend at the time of our death, then we will have to start serving Allah and stop serving and becoming the slaves of dunya. If you live a life of obedience, then it is hope that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give you a good death and Allah will honor you at the time of death. Nabi alayhi salatu wa salam said that you will die like you live. And وَتُحْشَرُونَ كَمَا تَمُوتُونَ. And you will be resurrected the way you die. If you lived trying to please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make you please at the time of your death and Allah will honor you at the time of your death. Look at the great Imam Ghazali. Everybody must have heard about the great Imam Ghazali, the author of Ihya al-Ulum. He performed wudu. He read the morning prayer. And then he asked for his kafan. He took his kafan, he kissed it, placed it on his eyes. And he said that I am ready and happy to present myself to the king. He lied down facing Qibla and Imam Ghazali was no more. Abu al-Hussein Maliki relates that I stayed in the company of Khair Nobar for many years, a wali of Allah. He says 8 days before he died, he told me that he's going to die on a Thursday and his janazah will be after Jumu'ah on a Friday. He says it totally slipped my mind, and when the Friday came, I was informed by somebody that my companion has passed away. I hurried to go for his funeral prayer. When I was making my way, I was told that his funeral is after janazah. I made my way to his house and I asked his relatives how he passed away. They said just before Maghrib he fainted. When he came round after a short while, he looked towards the corner of the room. We couldn't see anybody there. He looked towards the corner of the room and he said, wait for a short while. You've been ordered to do something and I've also been ordered by Allah to do something. Let me do what Allah has ordered me, then you can do what Allah has ordered you. He asked for water, he prayed his Maghrib, he lied down, and he was no more. Look at Hassan ibn Saleh relates that his brother Ali ibn Saleh, the night he died, he asked for water. Hassan ibn Saleh says, I was performing Salah. فَلَمَّا قَضَيْتُ صَلَاتِي أَتَيْتُهُ بِمَا When I finished Salah, I brought some water. And I said, Ishraq, drink. He said, شَرِبْتُ صَلَاتِ That I've just drunk the water. I was puzzled and confused. مَنْ تَكَاكْ وَلَيْسَ فِي الْغُرْفَةِ غَيْرِ وَغَيْرُ Who's giving you water? There was nobody inside the room besides you and I. He said, Sayyidina Jibreel has just come and he has given me water to drink. And Sayyidina Jibreel has given me glad tidings. كَأَنْتَ وَأَخُوكَ وَأُمُّكَ مَعَ الَّذِينَ أَنَّمَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِمْ مِنَ النَّبِيِّينَ وَصِدِّيقِينَ وَالشُّهَدَاء وَالصَّالِحِينَ That Sayyidina Jibreel said to me that you, your brother and your mother will be with those who Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has blessed. The Anbiya, the martyrs, the Siddiqeen, the Shuhada. Saying this, Ali ibn Saleh was no more. Look at Mu'adh ibn Jabal. The hadith reported by Ibn Asakir. Abdurrahman ibn Ghannam al-Ashri relates that when his son died, the son of Mu'adh ibn Jabal died from the plague of Amwat. When he died, Mu'adh ibn Jabal was very patient. But when he was hit by a spear in a battle, he said some strange things. Mu'adh ibn Jabal said that the friend has come for help. One who puts off his friend with excuses and regrets never meets with success. Abdurrahman gives it, when we heard these strange sentences, we asked, oh Mu'adh, are you seeing something that we are not seeing? Who are you speaking to? Sayyidina Mu'adh replied in the affirmative. But I'm seeing something that you are not seeing. Allah has just honored me for being patient at the time of the death of my son. My son has just come to me, giving me glad tidings that Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam, the angels of Allah, the martyrs, and the Sahaba have drawn up in 100 lines and they have come to say my funeral, and then Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam and the Sahaba will escort me to Jannah. Mu'adh ibn Jabal saying this fainted. The people say Mu'adh ibn Jabal was unconscious and we saw Mu'adh ibn Jabal shaking hands with somebody we could not see there. And he said to them, welcome, welcome, I am coming to you. Saying this, Mu'adh ibn Jabal was no more. This is how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala honors those who truly believe and those spend their life pleasing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah honors them and pleases them at the time of death. So when a believer is in his last throes of death, the devil first comes. And he tries his utmost best to lead him astray. The hadith which can be found in the Tazkirah of Imam al-Qurtubi is related. The Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam said at the time